Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. I'm so glad you stopped by. If you like videos like this and you want to see more, please subscribe and click the like button and also comment on any more pick threes that you'd be interested in having me do readings on. So, if you want to take a moment and think about how you choose men, and if you are one of those women, and there's a lot of them, who tend to pick men who are emotionally unavailable, this is for you. So you can choose option number one, option number two, or option number three. Take a moment to decide, and the links for two and three are in the comment section below. We're going to start out with those of you who selected option number one. So, what the cards have to say for guidance for you. We're going to first turn over the first one. Oh my goodness, Ace of Pentacles. There's a lot of deep red in this. And red can be passion. And like every time you think that you're in a new relationship, it can be the same old pattern. And the leaves are falling, meaning things can begin to fall. Second card is... wow, the Four of Pentacles. So this just means that you have a certain, see the gold coin? You're attracted to guys who are charming. Maybe they wear a lot of, you know, gold jewelry or they've got blingy tattoos or something. And here's a strength, you know, this their helping hand, like helpful guys, and they're strong and they're, you know, charismatic. And so you're going for more visual traits with this, and then shit hits the fan and they turn out to be angry. This is the Knight of Swords. Now, he not only starts in anger, starts fights, and then leaves, like if you have a disagreement with this guy, he's not gonna stick around to really sort this out. He's gonna have a lot of angry words, and he's just, and look at all the armor on him. He's really emotionally unavailable. For you guys who selected one, this is going to be a challenge for you because he really is got a lot of armor on. And look at the fire energy. Both of these, they're fighting. This in fact, it feels like you spend a good deal of your relationship in disagreement. Let's just put it nicely, in disagreement. This is all about fire energy, and that you want him to change, and you always think that every time it's going to start over that it'll be different and that this person will change. And so you always, you know, here you are giving more to him, giving more, then the fights and the whole pattern starts all over again. But here's the good news. So I always save the last card in the batch for the solution. And I don't know what these cards are. I mean, when I pick these cards out, you guys, I'm not looking at them. I'm shuffling them like as if you were sitting across the table from me and we're having a reading. So the Knight of Cups means that you've got to redefine how you love someone. So it can't be this bling anymore. You can't be attracted to the bling and maybe, you know, how successful they are. You've actually got to look deep into the heart of them. Are they kind? Are they kind person? Do they enjoy being around the same things that you do? Do they like animals? If you're an animal lover. And so spirit communicating to you is going to help you find a man that breaks your pattern, but you're going to have to cooperate. So first of all, you're going to have to look for somebody that you normally wouldn't be attracted to. So, like, I don't know if this is a hedgehog. You don't have to date a hedgehog. But somebody who looks a little different, they might not look like what you normally would want someone to look like. Okay, they're not going to look like that. They're not going to have all the bling. They get mad, but it's a healthy anger, and they're never going to do anything verbally abusive or mean to you. So this will never come out in them. And they can have the Wands qualities, because in the positive side of the Wands, this is somebody who's got, you know, enthusiasm. But ultimately, you're going to, you know, now let me tell you something. You have to also look at yourselves, number one, to see if you tend to pick men that create drama in your life? And if so, I'm going to ask you, do you create drama in other areas of your life? And if you do, I've got a future video coming to break that pattern. But this one's important to break because this is the person that you potentially could spend your life with. So this guy's calm. He's calmed down. He's not all fired up. See how he's not even looking at the fired up guy. He's like, nope, you don't need that fiery energy. You don't, and he's low drama. And he will love you to the moon and back. And so how do you break the pattern? Exactly as I said, you're going to date somebody that you're not really attracted to. He's going to have, he might get angry at things, but it's healthy. It's never attacking you. And he doesn't have to put himself in all this armor and start all these, see the fire energy? That's fights. That's fighting energy. All start all the fires. And the clouds are mental, mental stress, mental abuse in some cases. So you're not going to be attracted to him, but you are going to like the qualities that you wanted in someone, kindness, and he's very stable, he's very predictable, and he is very loving. So you guys are lucky that you're going to have a solution coming to you. You just have to work a little bit because it's hard to break a habit. It's hard to break a habit, depending on how long you've had the habit. If you've selected option number two, you're kind of pondering whether or not this video is really going to help you. You're like, I don't know. How am I going to transform into somebody else? But the very fact you selected number two, there's a lot of yellow in this card, and that means there's a great deal of potential for you. Look at you. You're a warrior. You're like, you know what? No mountain is too big for me to conquer. And this is going to be big because this is a pattern that you've had at least 2 to 3 to 4 times with relationships. And I also want to tell you, those of you who picked pile number two, is that you tend to also pick not only men who are emotionally unavailable, but men who have other interests, like they'll pick to do something else rather than spend time with you. Oh dear. This is what you do in your relationship. You just spar back and forth. It's just one thing after another. You don't like this about him. You don't like that about him. It's just you in battle mode all the time. That gets exhausting. Thank goodness this card came up because now you're like, huh, maybe I don't like that for my future. Maybe I don't want to have all that battling energy. And you guys are lucky because there's a beautiful angel that's going to be sending you messages. This card's been appearing a lot lately in these pick threes, and I'm completely reshuffling all these decks. So this angel really wants to come and help you. You have to ask. You have to ask angels. You tend to pick out guys that are muscular, they work out, they look tough. You want the tough guy because you're tough. So you want a tough guy because you're tough, but tough guy's not working for you. It's not working for you. So the last card is usually the solution card, and we have the queen. So you have to actually use your thinking mind. This is the queen, and she's turning her back on all of this. She's like, to hell with this. She's looking away. That's one of the things when I read cards, I always say, okay, who's interested in what? So she's just looking off. She's not even looking at the drama. Inside, you really want a peaceful relationship. You do not want all that drama. You've had to get tough because you had to grow up fast. Things were tough for you in life, and so you grew up tough. And then you pick these tough men, but along the path, you can have tough men. They just can't be unavailable for you. So whatever their past history is, they've put a wall up. See the stone wall? There's a wall there. That wall's not coming down. Stop picking men like that, right? But it's not that easy just to stop. So ask the angels. Ask the angels to come in and then use your thinking mind. Here, there's even an angel on the chair here. It's a little angel on the chair. Ask your thinking mind. You know what? Does it make common sense for me to be with this person if all we're doing is sparring back and forth and I have all these troubles and I've always got to be in battle mode and I have all this big list of changes that you need to make? Like, you need to pay attention to me or else, Who wants to have a relationship like that? Now, you are very intelligent. Those of you who selected number two, you're driven by your mind. And so you can do this. You can say, you know what? Here's my boundaries, this is my boundaries, and you gotta set your boundaries, and if they don't meet up to your standards, they're gone. You've got to have somebody who you those of you who pick number two wants a guy that you can have a good conversation with. You can engage, he cares about you, he does things with you, he's balanced, he knows how to handle things, and he does not get into these sparring matches with you. You want someone that you can have a discussion with if you have a difference, and it leads you to ponder. It's kindness. It's yellow. It's kindness. You want somebody who's compassionate and kind. And your angels are going to help you. So if you chose pile number two, your angels can't help you unless you ask for help. So I want you to ask your angels to send you the signs on how you can meet someone who will be emotionally available for you without being dependent on you or any type of major dysfunction. Now remember, the queen can expect perfection. No one's perfect. So those of you who have chosen pile two, you're going to have to let down some of these expectations that are, you know, over the top. Okay, let's just say they're over the top. You're going to have to be a little more forgiving that they're not going to have to be perfect men, but they're going to be emotionally available and they're going to be emotionally healthy. They don't have to be perfect. So, good thing your thinking mind is going to bail you out, those of you who selected option two. Those of you who selected option three, we're going to pull your first card. Woo! Aren't you dreamy? You're just riding your horse, having daydreams. I mean, you're just... This is an amazing card because you had this vision of your knight in shining armor carrying you away. I mean, this is kind of the card about having this dreamy outlook on life. I mean, you probably spend a lot of time thinking about how much better your life could be. Now, you're also a strong woman. You're compassionate. You love animals. This is just a card that... Even in relationships, look at now both. She's with an animal both times. So you guys really have a lot to give to someone in a relationship. You really do. And so this is interesting because see the veil here? There's a veil here. There's hidden. So you want this fairy tale story romance. You know, you want it to be like in the movies where you just live happily ever after. But they're covering this up. There's a veil of this. It's not happening in your life. And so what you've resorted to is like praying. You're like, oh my gosh, please send me the man of my dreams. And you know, that's fine. But I think what's going to have to happen is you're going to actually have to put the hoof to the pavements and realize that to meet a man who's emotionally available, you've got to be stand up there and make bet, you know, a choice that isn't based on the fairy tales in the movies, okay? Your message from this reading is, and here's your solution, by the way. I always save the solution for the last card. This is put all of your troubles away. And look at here, we have two praying cards. So it just means that you have to choose men that don't meet the fairy tale romance thing. Like if you're looking at, you know, the visual effects of them or, you know, there you could have an fear that it's possible that you have a fear that they're going to be like needy. Like if they're emotionally available to you, they're going to be needy. And that's not going to be the case at all. But your solution is literally to get out of your thinking mind. You're overthinking things too much. And the other side of it that I want to say is not to depend on this person to make happiness for you. You guys who are in option number three, get out of this fairy tale mode, okay? Get out of the fairy tale mode. You are going to have to create your own happiness. And then you will meet someone. You can throw the curtains down and be fully you. You don't have to walk on eggshells. And you don't have to resort to praying to the universe. You can allow yourself to wait and be patient. This card can talk about rushing in, like rushing into a relationship too quickly. So make sure that you've created your own happiness in your life and that you don't expect this person to make you happy, right? So you're already happy. You're not going to expect the fairy tale romance. And guess what? You are going to, if you're patient, you will meet someone who is emotionally there for you. And you guys who chose option number three, you have a really high potential of easily breaking this pattern. So, I mean, this is really a good sign. You guys are strong, you're compassionate, and you've got what it takes. You've got what it takes to break that pattern. It's just a matter of, this card talks about, don't rush into these relationships and don't fall in love like so quickly. Fall in love, be friends first, fall in love over time. Don't fall in love immediately, because that's a downfall for you guys. So not that it's, I'm not saying that you can't pray. I'm just saying, in order to meet somebody who's emotionally available for you, you've got to be more patient, and you've got to be approach it in a different way. If you approach relationships the same as you have in the past, you're going to end up with the same that you have in the past, and you'll repeat the pattern. And this, you have a chance to put the pattern on the wall and finally have a peaceful relationship, which is what you've always wanted. No conflicts, or very little conflicts in the relationship. So you guys are going to do great.